Hello, this is Dr. Quek again. Welcome to my video series on the 10 common mistakes by engineers in employing MSMA. This is video number 3 on the application of hydrological procedures. You can watch the YouTube video at the top URL. You can download this PowerPoint file in PDF format at the second URL. And please don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel to receive notification on my future videos. Here are the topics that I'll be covering in my 10 video series. Video 1 to 5, as listed here, and video 6, 7, to 8, 9, 10. I'll be showing you one video a week. Today is video number 3. Okay, let's get started. Are there any alternatives to MSMA for computing the peak discharges? Yes, there are two alternatives to MSMA. Notice that MSMA are mostly for urban catchments. Now we are talking about for rural catchments. There are two alternatives. The first is the flood frequency analysis, which involves the use of historical streamflow data. Second is hydrological procedure published by JPS. Let's go into more details. Flood frequency analysis. What is flood frequency analysis? It is based on historical streamflow data. Usually you have to obtain the data from JPS. And then you do a plotting on graph paper using the Weibull plotting position. It means you have to rank all the historical flood in terms of the magnitude from the highest to the second, third, fourth, and then plot it on a graph. The advantages of this approach is that it gives good assessment of the rural condition flow. In fact, if you compare all the methods, this is the method that is based on real data. So theoretically, this method would give more realistic estimate of the flood condition for rural catchment. The second alternative, hydrological procedure. These are the procedures published by JPS. These are empirical approach to estimate the peak discharges. The applicability depends on the catchment size and on the rural conditions. There are few procedures. Example are HP5, HP11 and HP4. Later in the presentation, I will give you the references to these three publications. Applicability of hydrological procedure. Here we compare the three hydrological procedures 5, 11, and 4 in terms of catchment area and the type of catchment. You can notice they are all for rural catchment, and two of them are based on rainfall data, as well as, and the last one is runoff base. It means the method itself, the derivation of the peak discharge is based on rainfall or based on runoff. So HP5, 11 and 4 can be used to estimate the peak discharge for rural catchment. example for pre-development scenario. There are differences in terms of the catchment area. So it's recommended to compare and to compute the estimate for all the methods. Let's look at HP11 in a little bit more details. What are the advantages of HP11? You can see HP5 is applicable for catchment above 0.3 km square, not less than 0.3. And HP4 is applicable for fairly large catchment, 20 km square. And these are not the range that we normally encounter for small catchment for urban development. Compared to the other two, HP11 is applicable for any catchment size less than 518 km square. So in terms of applicability, HP11 covers the range of the catchment area that we normally encounter. And then from experience, it gives good estimate of the rural peak discharge and also the hydrographs. It's important to take note that it gives an estimate of the hydrograph as well. So this is recommended for pre-development scenario. Example, in the design of detention basin, where you have to compare the pre- and post-development discharge, you can use it to compute the pre-development scenario. And another advantages of this HP11 is it can be used for the calibration of rainfall runoff model like HEC-HMS. Those of you who don't know about this, you can watch video number 2, where I talk about the HEC-HMS method, why this is a good method for us to estimate the design hydrograph for urban catchment. Earlier I mentioned I'll be giving you the references on the hydrological procedure HP5, 11 and 4. These are the references. I have a few special offers for the viewers of this video. Special offer number 1. You can sign up MSMA for free. The details are here. Special offer number 2. You can get hands-on training and the spreadsheet templates by attending the workshop. The details are here. Special offer number 3. You can sign up for the free one-day MSMA seminar. The details are here. Special offer number 4. You can download the free spreadsheet template like the one you watched earlier in the case study. You sign up here. Do you want to watch all my videos? You can subscribe to the YouTube link using this YouTube channel. Special offer number 6. Do you want to watch this video and download the PPT file? Details are here. Special offer number 7. Can I contact Dr. Quang if I have any question? The answer is yes. Details are here. Before I finish the video, I just want to highlight some of the benefits of attending the MSMA workshop. You can get practical hands-on training by attending the workshop. It's conducted by a trainer, myself, with 3 decades of experience in consultancy. And it complies with the authority requirement on MSMA. You can learn to optimize your design of drainage structures. You receive valuable spreadsheet templates, which you can bring back to your office. There are bonuses like spreadsheet template, software, and resource material given. You can sign up for free the MSMAware software. You can lifetime access to the G Drive to download the resource material, including tools and spreadsheet. You can access a special Facebook page where you can get posting on MSMA. New material will be added to the Share G Drive folder at regular interval. This will be announced on the Facebook page. The workshop is accredited by BEM. You gain up to 7 CPD hours per day. And the workshop is also accredited by HRD Corp and are claimable from HRD Corp. Finally, how to contact us? These are the contact details. You can email or call or WhatsApp us, and you can check our Facebook page.